for you. This is the starting 11 that he's putting out tonight against the rest of the world. And a very strong team it is too. And the rest of the world keeping Eric Cantona under wraps for the time being. A tremendous reception for Henrik Larsson, who scored for Sweden. For Sweden's benefit, but it also helped England on Saturday, of course. I think we can expect plenty of substitutions. And Benito Carboni in limbo somewhat at Sheffield Wednesday is going to get some football tonight. And Careca, the great Brazilian striker, 39 years old now, is here to play his part as well. Gascoigne trying to quicken it up to Weir. In goes a stamp. Wim Jonk. Last. Now Weir, a lovely play. In a Premiership game at Old Trafford, less serious circumstances tonight, but the goal scoring touch, George, is still there.
Terrific. I mean, that's the one player that the Old Trafford faithful didn't want to see score, but I think maybe I could have knocked that in as well. But a lovely move, a terrific goal, great ball inside the defender there,
and a perfect cross from Cafu. An invitation that Ali was almost embarrassed to accept. He knows what. The Ali pass to George Weir. Through to Markoli. Stoney on the outside, but the chance. I think scoring twice against Manchester United.
He wouldn't dare. Still a tricky
player. Off comes Wim Jonk and David Weir of Everton and Scotland.
And coming off number 10,
Tom Crickley, leaving the entrance now that the crowd really have come here in their thousands to see. Cantona is back at Old Trafford. Sheringham. Solskjaer. Decisive clearance in the first place by Rio Ferdinand. Right, a couple of minutes to go to half time. Don't think there'll be too much stoppage time. Don't think Alex Ferguson will have to get the watch out. But we'd like to see an equaliser before half time. We have seen it from Teddy Sheringham. That's what it means to get one over the great goalkeeper. George Best.
Well, I think that's what we needed just before half-time. It was very, very interesting. Great cross, and Keddie's already had a couple of half-chances. But got in there, headless defender, and still got past poor old Schmeichel. Schmeichel will not be happy, even though it's a friendly game.
Mike Riley brings the first half to a slightly premature close, and the crowd show their appreciation. Manchester United took 43 minutes to get the better of Peter Schmeichel. Gascoigne. Carboni and Careca. There's no flag, and there is a second goal for the rest of the world. He hasn't lost his touch when the chance materialises, and Careca makes it Manchester United 1, the rest of the world 2. George.
Yeah, terrific finish. I mean, you don't play for the greatest team in the world. 70 times have become finished.
Good. Sharing it. Moments of the night so far. We'll call this side Fergie's boys.
Number one, Peter Schmeichel.
Peter Schmeichel.
Number two, Paul Parker.
He'll come back on again. The essence of the selection here, the squad of players that helped Manchester United to the double in 94. Paul Parker, Clayton Blackmore. Bruce, now the manager of Huddersfield Town, of course, whose side could have gone top of Division 1 at the weekend. And Daisy and Dolly, as they were affectionately known in the dressing room for so many years, are reunited. Bruce and Pallister, Darren Ferguson. So when I say Fergie's boys, that's quite literally the case. Three sons, Darren Ferguson is now playing for Wrexham. North Wales, the Wales manager, Mark Hughes. Lee Sharp, who's only just got his fitness back, he's with Bradford City these days, and he may well play in the Worthington Cup later this week. And although David Beckham is not fully fit, he is going to take part tonight, and Hugh would begrudge him that. The last club to beat Manchester United in the league here. And Eric Cantona. Nice touch, George.
Wonderful. Some talent out there in there. How much is that worth?
That'll bring a nostalgic tear to many a Manchester United eye. The boys are back together. Cantona. Here's Paul Parker. First played for London in the World Cup of 1990. We shouldn't forget international time as well. Great fun now, George.
It's brilliant. Sparky's different fashion. Come on, he's probably played 15 minutes and got a hat trick here. Smashed it, lost one in his left, and the old Lightfoot has done business again. I mean, over the years, he's been one of the best target men in the world. Does a weekend with that.
Very serious piece of involvement. Concentrated on his own game. Been distracted by some of the other entertainment. York to goal! United get one back. a man who worked himself up from humble origins to the very top. And top names in football have come here to pay their respects. And Mark Hughes made a marvellous impact late on. The presence of Eric Cantona really guaranteed the gate for Full House. Great night, children.
Absolutely brilliant. Full House, a lot of money going to charity, worthwhile, and I think everyone's enjoyed it. We've seen six goals, a couple of specials from Hughesy, especially the first one. Some great touches. Some great, great players on the show, and it just shows the respect I have for this man.
Well, the